This illustrates the use of advisory signs on the M5 southbound. They were dealing with the aftermath of a crash south of Junction 11. The displayed speed is advisory, not compulsory here. On the climb up to the air balloon, there was a van crawling up the bank with its emergency lights on. It's possible for traffic in both lanes to turn right here. No heavy trucks at present. So far, so good. But look where it is now, in the wrong lane and slowing down, then cutting across in front with no advance indication at all. Evidently a customer of Aldi. hazardous overtaking here. And gained almost nothing, a couple of seconds at best. Well worth stopping for this move. That one could have stopped at the passing place, but didn't. OS and app users evidently probably didn't hear the car, as the engine would not be running here. Something edible in the road. All the OLE kit is installed now on the main line. Spot the sign behind the trees. The road surface is in poor condition between the police station and Sainsbury's. There should be three lanes here, one left only into Sainsbury's and two on through the roundabout. At least they've repainted the markings since the winter. Might have crossed the border between the DFT and the Council. Hitching a ride to Cirencester, rare these days. Measuring speed via GPS is dodgy on sharp curves, also via wheel speed of course. Incidentally, the Yaris' acceleration was fine in eco mode on this rising gradient. There will be an overbridge across the roundabout here. Not quite ready yet. lot of construction taking place on the right here, with protective netting for this part of the road. The old 465 would come into this roundabout from the left. This is a temporary arrangement. This roundabout will be off to the side in the final. And we're on to section 3, just about complete now, not on many maps yet. Lane 1 is for Ebervale, the other pair are the 465. Car had its automatic lamps on. Some do, some don't. This was the aftermath of an incident. And the police are just arriving. For the curious, the police car speed was roughly 100 kilometers per hour. According to local news, there was a third car involved, which wasn't there as I went past. Thank you. to Toddington via Bolton on the Water and over the hills. This is a working day, several trucks serving the quarries and farms. Across the 4068. Adam Henson's a presenter on the BBC Countryfile programme. Winding down the hill on the 4077. Parking in the field on the Stow side of the line. Back via Aschurch, then the M5 past Cheltenham, over the Gloucester to Birmingham line. Eightpence a litre more than Sainsbury's yesterday. busy towards Gloucester all the way back to Nettleton, the last stretch of single lane between the M4 and M5. So, it was an anti-clockwise round trip. This council sign should really show M4 West in the third lane here, so I should have stayed right for the M4 West. Tight move past a bike by a truck. and someone using the footpath instead of the road. That one's doing a U-turn. It's really the right turn exit from the checkpoint, otherwise it would be closed off. On the right, that car's moving across to lane 1 beside a slip road. Not a good place to do it. Evidently, it's a left-hand drive one.